He's an Emmy Award-winning executive producer, and he's interviewed everyone from President Obama to Ellen DeGeneres. Please welcome, from KFMB-TV, Simone Aponte, and from Fox 5 San Diego, Matt Johnson.
Oh my God, Simone, I'm so excited.
Okay, Matt, so who was better?
What do you mean?
Who was the better interview, President Obama or Ellen DeGeneres?
Oh, forget them. How about the jetpack fail guy?
Yes.
But enough about me. What do you think about me? How about for the nominees?
Let's take a look.
Arts entertainment, program or special. Vegas PBS Arts Showcase, Reginald LaFrance, Brian Siegel. Behind the Name, Remy Martin, Christina Sindrich. Sam the Cooking Guy Studio Show, Shannon Hall, Michelle Maddox, Sam Zine. Backbeat, Seymour Duncan Pickups, Lou Fontana, Michael Johansson. Health Science, Program or Special. Stories of the Sharp Experience, Rich Bademy, June Sattler, Arnie Lerner, Paula Berberick, Sonia Rhodes, Janet Clancy. Desert Tortoise Trouble, Daniel Garrison. Historical Cultural, Program or Special. Los Mejores Años, The Better Years. Carolina Sarasa, Adriana Arevalo, Ricardo Bonilla. Portrait of a Nation, Equatorial Guinea. Tiffany Steeves, Sabrina Heineke, James Brown. Informational Instructional, Program or Special. Galapagos Islands Conservation, Shay Johnson. Vida de Perros, A Dog's Life. Carolina Sarasa, Adriana Arevalo. The Eight Signs of Terrorism, Tammy Glenn, Dominic Fulgoni. Sam the Cooking Guy, Kraft Brew Day, Shannon Hall, Sam Zine, Sandra Torres. Magazine Program, Boys Toys, Fearless Florida, Jennifer Caldwell Barlow. Flipped Out, Mike Castellucci. Sign Spinners, Ned Augustenborg, Robert Baumgart.
All right, and the Emmys go to Backbeat, Seymour Duncan Pickups, Lou Fontana, and Michael Johansson.
Stories of the Sharp Experience, Rich Bademy, June Sattler, Arnie Lerner, Paula Berberick, Sonia Rhodes, and Janet Clancy.
Los Mejores Años, The Better Years. Carolina Sarsos, Adriana, I practiced that one too. Adriana Arevalo, and Ricardo Bonilla.
Vida de Perros, A Dog's Life, Carolina Sarasa, Adriana Arevalo.
The Eight Signs of Terrorism, Tammy Glenn and Dominique Fulgoni.
And Flipped Out, Mike Castellucci.
And every pickup that I worked on, I would write all the specs to. So we have a real good library of all the whole world market of whatever pickup is out there.
Feet flew out from underneath her.
I've fallen like that plenty of times, and I guess this time was just the last straw.
I keep waiting to wake up. This didn't really happen.
No se fija en el género, ni en la apariencia, ni mucho menos en el estatus social. La realidad es que todos y cada uno de nosotros llegaremos a su encuentro. Ellos corren, se divierten y necesitan amor y atención como cualquier otra mascota. El único problema para este cachorrito es que esta noche la pasará en una de estas jaulas.
But some of the things that make our region such a great place to live can also put us at risk. We're home to a large military community, an international airport, a busy port, and many venues where large crowds gather.
We take snapshots, really, from the photo album of the human condition.
It's like recording a thumbnail sketch of humanity with a pinky-sized camera.
An entire show.
I just wanted to say, you know, we started this show about a year and a half ago. And when we started this show, everyone asked, how many episodes are you going to do? And I figured probably maybe six. Six of them would. But you know what? We found enough in the community as far as music that I think invades everyone's life. The episode that we won was Seymour Duncan, the maker of guitar pickups, probably the biggest maker in the world. And every community on the planet has musicians and has music makers like that. So we started the show, and my producer and co-producer, Lou Fontana, has been probably the biggest supporter and probably made the show as far as the look. And Cox Communications and my boss, Brock Hoffman, has continued to give us the time on Cox 8 to be able to have Backbeat. And Shannon Decker. Here we have, this is our crew right here, by the way. And Shannon Decker has stepped up, and she has probably been the best host, and we've had many on the show. So I just want to thank all of them, and Seymour Duncan especially, for being on our show. Thank you very much.
Well, this is really special because this is the 10th anniversary episode of Stories of the Sharp Experience, which has been an incredible demonstration of the power of television to inform and to educate. I mean, all of us here on the stage are much appreciative of this award. Janet Clancy, Paula Berberg from Sharp Healthcare, Sonia Rhodes, godmother of the Sharp Experience, who's going to be leaving our team this year. This is her final episode working on this project. And June Santler, our producer for a decade on this project. But I also want to recognize some people behind the scenes that have been with us for a very long time. Kevin King, our amazing editor. Michael Batamy on post-production, and especially Colleen Murphy, registered nurse, who has been the face of this program and the face of Sharp Healthcare for a very long time. Colleen, stand up and take a bow. Are you out there? Thank you so much.
Well, this is very, very important for me. I have to thank all my family, of course. Everybody's in the line hearing right now from Florida, Las Vegas, everywhere. And I have to say that this is the result of team effort, team job. And Carolina, you know, this is the first time that we went together. And she just told me that she's leaving me, so. Congratulations, and this is the best way to say goodbye.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Amy. Thank you, Adriana. To my husband, for my parents, of course. I did this story. Thank you to my parents. And to Ricardo, who recorded the story.
Mom, Dad, thanks for the opportunity.
Luis Fed, you should be here. Thank you, everybody.
Well, I know some news stations don't want to waste your time with light stories, but let me waste a little of your time. There is a place in newscasts for the lighter stories, storytelling. That's what journalism, in my opinion, is all about. And it's usually the ordinary people with the extraordinary stories, and I really appreciate this. It means a lot. Thank you.